All right, here we go. Back at it again. This is Stacy here from Dissecting Athletics. We are here back with our owner mode. This is our third episode. Last time we went through some of the extra modes in this game. So let's go ahead and check out what's been going on since last time we played. Last time we just went through the first game of this owner mode and checked out some of the team and the rosters and all that. So let's go back and let me show you what changes I've actually made, because there's been a lot of changes to this team since last time. All right, so right now I've got Jerry Hairston playing center field. Before he was at second base, and I had, who was it? I had Julio Lugo at shortstop. Right now I've got Bobby Crosby at shortstop. I had to make a trade for him. So you remember Williamson was playing right field. I traded him. I think in order to get Marcus Giles, you see he's really good against lefties. Okay against righties, but he's batting like 330. He was an all-star. I got him right at the all-star break. Let's see, Surhoff, he kind of declined a little bit. He's back up now to 248. He was in the 230s, so I had to take him out of the starting lineup, but he's still been pretty solid. He's one of the top home run hitters on this team right now. He's got 20 home runs. Phil Johnson is 254 with 3 RBIs. He's still my backup. So Taguchi, he's a good defender. Check out those defending stats. Pretty good in left field or center field. Grady Sizemore right now is on my bench because I have him batting, let's see, he's batting 258. So it's okay. He's got 14 home runs, 65 RBIs. That's pretty solid production considering his stats are not that great. But Jason Wirth is hitting 324, and I wanted to keep him in there. He's a slightly better defender as well. Obviously really good against lefties. So, I mean, I could, you know, platoon them, but Grady Sizemore was also injured. I think he just came back from injury. So I'll probably put him back against righties in a little bit. I don't have a backup shortstop, so right now Crosby's been getting a lot of playing time. He's really good against, he's not... His stats aren't too great, but his contact and power aren't that great. But that's pretty good defense. 80s at least for everything. Fielding range, throwing strength. Durability is 80. But he's batting... Oh, wow. He's only batting 248. That's... I believe he was... Wait, no. Just kidding. Yeah, so you got his power, contact, everything. He's batting 266 on the year, so that's pretty solid. Good enough to be a ninth or eighth place hitter. 12 home runs, 52 RBIs. Right now, Pujols is crushing it. He had a slow start, but now he's up to 318 with 44 home runs, 110 RBIs. He's gonna get up there, probably over 50 home runs to end the season. Jerry Hairston's batting 268. Marcus Giles at 330. Eric Chavez was way down at like 240 before. Now he's up at 288 with some pretty good production. Paul Aduca, I had him at second, hitting second for most of the year. But he was, you know, he was driving in some runs, so I wanted to put him in the fifth spot. Also, we had Marcus Giles, and I thought he was a little bit better as a second place hitter. Al Kaline right here is actually one of the guys that I picked up. So if you remember in the last video, I mentioned that I got some more of the legendary players. And I actually signed Kaline, and I signed Phil Niekro, who's a knuckleballing starter. So that kind of really messed up my budget, but you know, that's a better team now. So I did release Al Leiter. You know, try to keep the rosters a little bit more even. I didn't want to, like, you know, cheat my way through the whole game, but I did want some more power and a little bit more fun in here. So see how Kaline's getting some good production in there. Adam LaRoche I picked up as well. He was batting up over 300 for a while. I had him in the three spot, but then I moved him down once his average started dropping a little bit. But he's only 25, so I expect him to be a better first baseman. You remember I had Adrian Gonzalez as my first baseman before. LaRoche is actually way better on defense. His fielding is a 95. So I've got him at first. I traded away Gonzalez. So got rid of a couple of prospects. Like Gonzalez and Matt Williamson were expected to be like future all-stars in this game. So I did get some good return on them. All right, and then let's check out the pitching rotation real quick. Kerry Wood's still up there. He's pitching pretty poorly, actually. He's got a, let's see. Yeah, so right now he's at 3.93. I believe he was over 4.50 for his ERA for a while. He's 10-10 now, so he's been pitching good in the last few games. I think those were the games that I played with him, like, manually. And he's pretty easy to pitch with. So Phil Niekro is in the Cy Young race. He's got 2.43 ERA, but he's 12-10. Now Horacio Ramirez is 5-15, but with a 3.82 ERA, so he's probably just not getting much help on offense. Bruce Chen is my fourth place starter, and he's 16-5 with a 3.15. And if you've seen Bruce Chen pitch in real life, I don't think he throws over 90. If you're a White Sox fan, you know that. If you're a White Sox fan, you know that. Ken Harrelson, Hawk Harrelson, always calls him Cy Chen because he manages to destroy the White Sox every time he used to pitch against them when he was with the Royals. And now he was actually in the race for Cy Young in this game for this team a little while ago, but his ERA is up to 3.15, so he's probably not in that conversation anymore. And then we have Jose Cruz, who is 5.48, but he's 8-9, so like compared to Ramirez, 5-15 with 3.82. 8-9 with a 5.46, so, you know, the record doesn't mean all that much. My bullpen was really solid for a long time, but their ERAs have started to go up a little bit. In the last couple games, I brought them down by playing manually because I guess I'm better than the computer. Joe Nathan only has 17 saves for all the wins that we had. But he's got a 222. These guys are okay. Crane Ayala was, for some reason, half of these guys don't get many innings. I had Ayala at my setup man before, and for some reason, like, my team is either winning by a lot or losing, so there's been no reason to have a setup man come in or my closer, so I guess they haven't been getting as many innings. You see Jesse Crane's got 66 innings. He had a 4.64 ERA, but let's see, Brandon League's up there too. But Felix Rodriguez only has 33 innings pitched, even though he's a lot better. So that's my pitching rotation. Let's see what else we got here. Let's check out the. All right, let's go around the league. Let's check out the standings right now. We are in second place in the league in the division at 72-64. Let's see. We're tied for first in the AL wildcard race. Remember that this is back in 2005, so they only had one wildcard spot. So right now the Angels and are a little bit lower, but we're racing against the Tigers, who are in our division. And we'll check out the schedule in a little bit, but I think we play them a few more times before the end of the season. And the Indians are just crushing it. Let's see. We don't have as many runs scored. The Royals are scoring 716 runs, but their pitching is just horrible. Here's the schedule. So we're in September and October. Right now we got 6 against the Royals. We've got 3 against the Angels. 6 against the Twins. 4 against the Tigers, so this is going to be the big series right here. That's going to be, you see the game impact on the first screen. You see impact 666. Oops, 666. So it's 6 against the Indians and 4 against the Tigers. Those games are probably going to be a 10 out of 10 in impact, because really that's what the playoffs are going to come down to for us. Let's see, last month we went 6-12, 13-13, so we've been like at 500. May was pretty good, April was bad, so you just kind of stayed afloat for most of the season. And yeah, time to turn it on. I'm actually going to sim all the way through to the Tigers game, to the Tiger series, and I'll show you how simming works, because this game has horrible simming. I know I mentioned in one of the episodes that I would be doing, and I know I mentioned in one of the episodes that I would be doing an episode on, you know, the negative parts of this game, the things that weren't very good, and I'll probably do it after this because I wanted to show you the end of this owner's mode before we actually get into that, because yeah, this is just a little bit more exciting. Oh, and I forgot to show you the actual owner mode part of it, the finances and whatnot, but it's going pretty horribly right now. I think we're like 15 million in the hole, so we're really going to need to win a championship for any kind of budget increase. And I'm not sure what's going on with payroll either, because my payroll is only about 110 million, and you know, it's pretty reasonable for a team to have like, what is it, about 150 million, like a big market team is probably 150 to 200 million dollars of a payroll, so that's not too ridiculous. See, the simming right now is going a little bit quicker because there's no minor league games, but when there's minor league games, it takes forever. 83-71, that's pretty decent. 84-71, so see, we've won a lot of games. I think we've won all the series so far, except this Royals series. So that's pretty good. We're 10 and a half games back of the lead. Schedule right now, we are still tied with the Tigers. All right, so we're 10 and a half games back. Playing the Tigers, 84-71, both of us right now. Only one of these teams is going to go to the playoffs. But remember, it's not a one-game playoff. It's a whole, you know, series against the first place team in the league. Yeah, there's the bank. Okay. Minus 20.1 million. And my revenue is pretty low. I think that's the biggest thing, because my expenses, 121 million, is not ridiculous. But I do want to kick up the ticket prices right now. And I don't know why this game impact is only a 7 out of 10. I guess the last week of the season is going to be a 10 out of 10, but let's go to Owner's Box and set the pricing. Go a little bit higher, because these games are probably going to get sold out. See, those couple games did get sold out. Last four home games. Yeah, so I definitely wanted to increase those in concession pricing. Gonna kick that up a little bit. I don't have any money to buy assets or anything, so that's why there's no like change in how much I can actually generate. It's really just about ticket pricing right now. I'm gonna go ahead and play two of these games. I'll play, let's see who's pitching in this one. All right, so Kerry Wood is pitching this first game, so I'm gonna go ahead and play that game. And I'll do a gameplay on it and associate it with this video. And then I'll come back and simulate the rest of the season. Or I might play a couple more games, I'll let you know. But we'll simulate to the end of the season, and then we'll do some gameplay of the playoffs. Just so we can separate the videos a little bit. But so that's what's going on with this owner mode right now. So we'll jump into that Tiger series for the next video. And in that gameplay, I'll explain some of the negative parts, like I was mentioning before, about the game itself. So, thank you for watching, and click on the next video, and you'll see some of that gameplay right there. Peace!